Hi, I'm Itoka. I'm trying to prove this inductive problem about the depth first search in Isabelle HOL. Since the function DFS is defined recursively, probably I can prove this conjecture using proof by induction. Let's apply the induction tactic on Nexus. Then apply auto. We still have proof obligations. How about induction on YS? Or induction on G? Induction on G is not promising either. Isabelle, you have to try harder. Now I invoked a tool called TryHard. TryHard conducts an expensive proof search trying to find the right combination of arguments for the induction tactic. This tool works pretty well for easy inductive problems. But for difficult inductive problems, the search space tends to be too large for TryHard to complete a proof search. And when it can't find a proof, it can't make a recommendation. Okay, Isabelle, get rid of conjectures. The automation of proof by induction is a long-standing challenge in computer science. In the introduction, I applied the induction tactic, trying to prove the inductive problem. But I didn't know which arguments to pass to the induction tactic. So I resorted to a brute force search, which unfortunately didn't find a proof. This means we need a tool to predict how to apply induction without completing a proof search. That's why I developed Smart Induct, and let's see how it works. We are trying to prove this inductive problem. Instead of applying TryHard, let's apply Smart Induct. If we wait for a while, Smart Induct produces these recommendations. Now we can copy this recommendation to the right location in the proof document with a single click. Since Smart Induct doesn't rely on a proof search, I'm not completely sure if this recommendation is correct. So, let's try to prove the emerging subgoals. First, we apply auto. Okay, it worked. The second subgoal seems a bit challenging, so we apply sledgehammer. Okay, sledgehammer says it found the proof. And we can finish this proof this way. After finding this proof script, we don't need Smart Induct anymore. So we can remove it to clean up the proof script. That's how Smart Induct works from user's perspective. Now let's look at what happened inside Smart Induct. When we invoked Smart Induct, it produced variants of combinations of arguments for the induction tactic. This part is not particularly smart. It naively produces many candidates without knowing which combination would be a good candidate. In step 2, Smart Induct applies various induction tactics produced in step 1 to the proof goal at hand, and it quickly checks if each candidate is worth further investigation. For example, step 2 checks if a candidate induction returns any results within a predefined timeout. If an induction tactic does not return anything, we can't proceed with a proof attempt. So, Smart Induct discards such combinations of arguments in step 2. In step 3, Smart Induct applies 19 heuristics to evaluate the remaining candidates. Each heuristic is a function that takes a proof goal at hand and the arguments passed to the induction tactic. The function returns true if the arguments are compatible with the heuristic, but it returns false if not. For each heuristic, Smart Induct gives certain predefined points to each remaining candidate if the heuristic returns true for that candidate. After applying 19 heuristics to all candidates, we reorder the remaining candidates to present the most promising ones in the output panel. I guess at this point you are wondering what kind of heuristics we used to develop smart induct. But explaining 19 heuristics one by one is not very informative. So instead of that, let me clarify one thing. It's difficult to encode induction heuristics that are not specific to particular problem domains. To encode induction heuristics for smart induct, first we looked at existing proof scripts and learned how to use the induction tactic. Maybe we had this proof script about two reverse functions. However, when users invoke smart induct, they have their own proof goals. Maybe a user wants to prove something about the execution of an abstract stack machine. This proof goal consists of new constants, new variable names, and new types. In the slide, I used the blue color to denote what we can see while developing smart induct. And I used the red color to represent what will appear after I release smart induct. These constants, names, and proof goals in red come into existence after we develop smart induct. But still, we want smart induct to recommend how to apply induction to this new proof goal. This means induction heuristics we encode should be able to analyze problems that do not exist yet. In the beginning, I was encoding such induction heuristics in Isabelle's implementation language, which is standard ML. But it was too tricky to encode such heuristics in general purpose programming language like standard ML. So we implemented our own domain-specific language specifically designed to encode induction heuristics in a domain-agnostic style. This language is called Lifter. If you are curious about Lifter, please have a look at our paper. The most important question about smart induct is its performance. Does it provide accurate recommendations, you would ask? To answer that question, we evaluated smart induct using 5 theory files with 109 proofs by induction from the archive of formal proofs. For these 109 proofs by induction, we counted how often the recommendations of smart induct coincide with the choices of human engineers. This is the result. The blue bars indicate how often smart induct recommends the choices of human engineers as the most promising induction tactic. On the other hand, the green bars are labeled as top 10, so green bars indicate how often the choices of human engineers appear among the top 10 most promising candidates recommended by smart induct. Challenge, DFS, Goldstein, NN, and PST are abbreviations for theory names, and you can find the overall results at the right end in this figure. I guess the first thing you noticed in this figure is the poor performance for NN, which stands for nearest neighbor. So it's natural to imagine that the performance of smart induct heavily depends on problem domains. But if you look at these theory files closely, you might notice that the performance gap might come from the different styles of induction. In this figure at the lower left, we counted how often proofs by induction have any argument in the rule field of the induction tactic, and how often proofs by induction involve variable generalization. As you probably noticed, most proofs by induction in NN involve variable generalization. And I think this caused smart induct's poor performance for the theory file. In fact, when we count coincidence rates for NN again while ignoring variable generalization, the performance of smart induct is not that bad. Now we rearranged the coincidence rates for the same evaluation set based on the use of the rule field and variable generalization. W stands for with and WO stands for without. For example, the leftmost group reads W rule W arb. This means the induction tactic has an argument in the rule field and the arbitrary field, which we use for variable generalization. Again, we can confirm that smart induct performed poorly for those problems that require variable generalization. So I have to admit that I didn't solve the problem of generalization heuristics. Now we know that we have an unsolved problem about proof by induction. Am I doing something about this? Sure, we have a new version of smart induct, which is developed in a new domain-speak language. I will release this new version soon, so stay tuned. Before finishing this video, I should talk about the execution time of smart induct. Unfortunately, we can't tell how long it takes for smart induct to produce recommendations in advance, because the time necessary for smart induct varies for different problems. So sometimes we have to wait for a while. This figure ordered each invocation of smart induct in the evaluation set based on the execution time. Note that we are using the logarithmic scale for the vertical axis, which means smart induct works pretty fast for some proof goals, but it can be very slow as well. Okay, let's summarize what we covered today. Today we introduced smart induct. Smart induct is a recommendation tool that suggests how to apply induction in Isabelle HOL without relying on a proof search. Smart induct is not specific to problem domains. This means you can apply smart induct to arbitrary inductive problems. Our evaluation showed that smart induct produces good recommendations about induction terms. However, it's not good at recommending which variables to generalize. Also, it can be pretty slow for some problems. That's all for today. Thanks for watching this video. Smart induct is available at our GitHub repository for free. If you enjoy, visit our repository and subscribe to our YouTube channel. See ya!